Hi, my name is Wouter Emery and I'm the founder of AirShaper. In this video, we'll explain to you how difficult it is to keep your solar panels from flying away. And sadly, it's true. Solar panels can really fly. And about a decade ago, reports of damage to and by solar panel systems were quite common after each storm. So what happened? Well, although the panels themselves are quite similar in most cases, the method and scale of the mounting system can differ a lot. On a small scale, for example, you could install perhaps 20 solar panels flush to the angled roof of your house. On a large scale, you can have arrays of thousands and thousands of solar panels installed on the flat or nearly flat roofs of industrial buildings. Let's focus on the flat roof systems. Because penetrating the waterproof coverage for anchoring purposes is not always an option, many operators just put ballast or weight on the mounting system to keep things down. This avoids a leakage problem, but it adds a new one, the extra weight. And with dozens of kilograms per panel, this easily adds up to multiple tons in total, which can be too much for the roof to carry. A decade ago, when no norms were available yet to determine the right amount of ballast to keep the panels down, some applied more safety than others. And with the financial crisis at full force back then, there was yet another incentive to keep the total weight of the system below the capacity limit of the roof, to get the projects approved and profitable. Nowadays though, through extensive wind tunnel testing and simulations, norms have been created and it's clear and simple. Follow the norms to determine the ballast that you need. Still, there's room for optimization, as the norms often take the aerodynamic properties of the system into account. So prior to final wind tunnel testing and certification of a system, it makes a lot of sense to integrate simulations into the R&D phase to optimize its aerodynamic properties. So back to the main topic, solar panels can fly. To illustrate this, we analyzed a single freestanding panel and put it in an airflow of 40 meters per second. Under headwind, the vertical lift generated on the panel is 240 kilograms. So the weight of the panel itself, which is around 20 kilograms, is not nearly enough to keep it down. This happens because the solar panel much behaves like a wing profile. The air hits the bottom side of the solar panel, creating a high pressure zone pushing the panel upwards. At the top, the air separates as it wants to jump across the solar panel, creating a suction effect that again pulls the solar panel upwards. And even if the wind hits the panel at a large angle, generated lift forces can still be as high as 100 kilograms. If you look at the same panel receiving headwind, but placed inside an array with neighbors on the left and the right, we see that lift values actually increase. Why? Well, the single panel had escape routes for the air on left and right, making it easier to escape. But when there's neighbors on left and right, the only way for the air is upwards, increasing the pressure buildup underneath the panel. You can also see that panels on the second, third and fourth row feature lower lift values or even downforce in some cases. This is why that the ballast values for panels on the outsides of an array are typically much higher than the ones located in the middle. Now if we rotate the entire array by 45 degrees, we see some other interesting effects. Obviously, the vertical lift is the highest on the corner panel, but it's still lower than in the headwind case. Also, the lift that we see on the front row panels decreases rapidly as we move away from the corner. Still, the values are way too high to compensate by ballast. This would crash the roof. So to reduce the wind load on the system, typically plates are installed, something called backplates. These shield the solar panel from the wind getting underneath, and this reduces the pressure buildup, which in turn reduces the vertical load on the system. To illustrate this effect, we have equipped our isolated panel with such a backplate. The air now hits this plate and jumps up, pushing this plate and the total system downwards. The total lift on the system has been decreased dramatically and even turned into downforce at some angles of the wind. The solar panel itself, however, can still feel the suction effect of the air jumping over the backplate. To counter that, there are some innovative systems that feature an intended opening at the top of the backplate. The suction effect, which is the largest just at the top of this backplate, will now help draw air from underneath the panel. This helps to both reduce the pressure underneath the panel and to reduce the suction effect at the top of the panel. And the effect on the vertical forces is quite clear, as you can see in this graph. Complex wind flow structures around buildings, influenced by the surroundings and featuring strong wind gusts, add multiple layers of complexity to the problem. So complementing your simulations with physical wind tunnel tests and adding the right safety factors is key to keep your panels from flying away. So that was it for this video. Thanks a lot for watching. If you liked it, click the like button, and I'm looking forward to see your comments and shares. Thanks a lot. See you soon. Bye bye.